Today on Matters of Fact, President Duterte has delivered on his promise of a new autonomous region in Muslim Mindanao. But that was seen largely as something for the Moro Islamic Liberation Front, the largest Muslim rebel group in the Philippines. He still has to deal with some unfinished business with Nur Misuari's Moro National Liberation Front. Joining us today is Father Eliseo Mercado Jr., Senior Policy Advisor of the Cotabato City-based think tank, the Institute for Autonomy and Governance. He was part of the Consultative Assembly of the Southern Philippines Council for Peace and Development, or SPCPD, during the three-year transition from the 1996 peace agreement between the government and the MNLF. He also served briefly as Chief Government Negotiator with the MILF during the Arroyo administration. Good morning, Father, and thank you for joining us.
Good morning, Christian, and good morning sa lahat ng abating TV watchers.
Okay, we laid down the context there because you have the MILF and you have the MNLF. Now, here we see that President Duterte is also trying still to address the problem posed by Nur Misuari's MNLF. Let's start with discussing what exactly Nur Misuari wants at this point.
At this point, inarticulate naman ni Chairman Nur Misuari na is all for federalism. Kanyang federalism is one Mindanao. But open naman siya siguro sa two Mindanao. And it so happened also na yung kanyang advocacy for federalism is the same advocacy ni President Duterte. So ibig sabihin na mayroong convergence yung desire ni President Duterte tsaka yung desire ni Nur Misuari to move towards federalism for Mindanao particularly. And then second, very important also, alam din siguro ni President Duterte na kasi yung previous administration ng before Duterte, they thought na Misuari and the MNLF niya under him ay spent force kaya puno sila sa margin. Pero hindi man totoo yun ang reality. In fact, that buhay na buhay yung MNLF at buhay na buhay din si Nur Misuari na mayroong international recognition. So the president thinks that Misuari is a big elephant in the room that has been ignored. So ngayon he pays attention to this big elephant because he believes that pwede mang masama si Nur Misuari sa overall plan ng Mindanao ng peace and development.
So just to be clear about it, Nur Misuari is not someone that Duterte can afford to ignore.
And no administration can ignore also something like that.
But how strong and influential is Nur Misuari still in that particular faction of the MNLF?
Sabihin natin yung island provinces, particularly Sulu, are basically MNLF under Nur Misuari. And good portion din ng Maguindanao, Nur Misuari din. Ano? Meaning to say is that it is it's not a spent force. Considerable pa rin yung force ni Moro National Liberation Front. Ang happy lang tayo na mayroong agreement din between Philippine government and the MNLF yung 1996. Kaya lang yung future niyan dinidetermined. Kaya nga siguro, I suppose, the president would like to create that coordinating council. Now, once again, let us take a look at what Misuari desires. At baka yung kanyang what he desires, what he wants, nandun man din sa broader perspective ng agenda ng presidente.
Okay. Now, was Nur Misuari's MNLF actually shortchanged given the progression from the Tripoli Agreement in 76, he had the 1996, na-improve naman supposedly yung ARM, and now you have the BARM. Was he actually shortchanged given that particular progression?
Kasi walang continuum, no? Merong break. No? So from 1976 Triple Agreement ano, to the 1996 Final Peace Agreement, merong continuum. Ang bida dyan is ang MNLF under the leadership of Nur Misuari na under the auspiciousship ng Organization of Islamic Conference o OIC. Yung bago ngayon na BARM na doon, sabihin natin, much improved than the autonomous region in Muslim Mindanao, hindi yun ang continuum kasi is isang trajectory yun ng Moro Islamic Liberation Front na they have the separated, they have a separate negotiation at meron ka lang separate agreement noong 2014 at ang culmination niyan nga yung Republic Act 11054, the creation of the Bangsa Moro Autonomous Region in Muslim Mindanao. So walang continuum, kaya nga nag-break yun.
So what should have been the approach of the government? Because you had two peace tables then.
Right.
Nagkaroon ka ng MN tapos MILF. But this one, but to be fair to the government, most of those promises naman I suppose were delivered.
Meron dalawang pagtingin doon. Two perspectives, the perspective ni Nur Misuari ng MNLF, tsaka perspective ng government. Yung previous administration believed that all the commitments na made under the 1996 agreement had been fulfilled. Pero si Nur Misuari, hindi, merong outstanding issues, ano?
Yung mga contending
issues, mm-hmm. ano? So, lalo lang yung just a period of transition. Isa na ako sa transition noon, eh, no?
Yeah, you're part
so,
of that.
Part of the transition. Ang point ko lang doon is that, ang importante, si Misuari, hindi kasali dito sa bago, eh, no? Yeah. Sa Bangsa Mga Autonomous si Muslim Mindanao. Ang nakasali dyan ay yung faction of the Moro National Liberation Front, but not the main faction ng MNLF.
I think it's Sema, Misuari. The one that
Sema and Jakiri, no? Na they are part now of the Bangsa Moro Transition Authority. Eh kung magsalita ang gobyerno, the MNLF is part and parcel of the BTA at ng BARM. Pero eh, palagay ko naman eh, we should distinguish yung reality tsaka propaganda. No? Okay lang, pampropaganda yan. But the moment we begin to believe our propaganda is another thing. Mm-hmm. Because there is a big elephant in the room and that is Nur Misuari and his MNLF. So ang desire siguro ng presidente is to bring them together in that coordinating council. Kung merong possibility to bring them together. I believe naman na may kakayahan ang presidente, no? Because si Nur Misuari is a good friend ni Duterte at ang MILF naman a good friend also ni Duterte. So ang common sabi natin ground nila ay ang presidente na hindi nagawa ng OIC because OIC has been trying from the very beginning to reconcile the MI and the MN.
Which they haven't succeeded.
Na hindi they did not succeed. Baka mag-succeed naman si Mang Duterte, I do not know. Oo.
Let's see, because Nur Misuari also did not participate in the BARM process.
No, he did not participate.
He wanted something else.
He wanted talaga nasa federalism track siya for the whole Mindanao.
But what if the administration fails to deliver on its federalism promise? There was a threat supposedly from Nur Misuari that he would
continue his rebellion. Oh,
yeah, continue his rebellion.
Oh. But the man is a rebel and we know naman na that's part and parcel of his tradition. Ano? May mga tao dyan, rebel forever. But meron siyang cause. But Nur Misuari is the icon kasi ng Bangsa Moro struggle. In the same way as Salamat is the icon also of the MILF struggle. There are two icons. Ano? Nag-pass away na si Sheikh Ustad Salamat. So ang natitirang talagang prominent icon will be Nur Misuari. There are three of them sa history siguro na very prominent sa lalo sa Teka Mindanao, si Maas Kamlon, ano? Isa yung icon talaga ng Bangsa Moro struggle in the 50s. Pero na-pick up lang yan ni Nur Misuari in the 70s at in the late 70s ni Ustad Salamat. These are the three icons ng Bangsa Moro struggle. Mm-hmm. Ang natitira na lang dyan sa icon na yan ay si Nur Misuari. So he remains the icon.
Mm-hmm. Now, but in this case, how will that actually solve the issues raised by Nur Misuari? Because you now have the bar. Mm-hmm. And this is espousing a One Mindanao proposal under the federalism setup.
Right.
So what will happen now to BARM?
Palagi ko,
what's the vision there?
Because BARM is basically autonomous structure. So the way the chairman perceives it, that okay, mag-proceed ang BARM within that federal state of Mindanao. Actually, within the federal state of Mindanao, there will be several regions that will be autonomous. Mm. Not only the BARM, you know? So he is open, Nur Misuari is open to several autonomous setups within that federal state, which can be the model for other states in a federal form of government. Now, within a federal state, you have autonomous territories within the same state.
But what problems or issues can a One Mindanao state address that the current BARM cannot?
Ang masasabi natin dito, number one, is that ang perception kasi is that BARM is a Muslim, ano? Mm. Which is not true. Dapat more inclusive.
It's more of Central Mindanao.
Oh, Central. Hindi lang Central Mindanao, but isolated province of Lanao, Sur, and Maguindanao. Sultan Kudarat is not even part of it. North Cotabato is not part of it, except for some barangays, ano? So, ang point dun, ang perception pa dyan, parang nakaseparate sila mga Muslim Bangsa Moro doon sa Maguindanao at saka sa Lano de Sur. Ang perception ni Chairman Nur Misuari is One Mindanao. It is, we are all stakeholders in Mindanao beyond sabihin natin ng religion, ethnicity, tsaka ng mga territories na yan, mga boundaries na ang ano. Ngayon makikita mo chunks of territory here and there na iko-question yung sustainability. Well, with Nur Misuari, it is one whole Mindanao and magiging sustainable yung state na yun. Kasi hindi lang yan para sa mga Muslim, hindi lang yan para sa mga indigenous people, hindi lang yan para doon sa mga settlers, sa mga Christians, kundi all Mindanao, kaya one Mindanao.
Basically geographic.
No? Oh, geographic na, and then people, so also people.
Pero how realistic is that push, Father, at this time?
Palagay ko kung magkakaroon ng partnership si President Duterte tsaka si Nur Misuari in pushing that one Mindanao, eh peaceable eh. Very popular si President Duterte sa Mindanao. At sabi ko nga, si Nur Misuari still remains an icon. So ngayon, there are two remaining icons for Mindanao leadership, and that will be Nur Misuari and President Duterte. And with the popularity, phenomenal, the word is phenomenal popularity ng President Duterte, kahit ako minsan critical, I accept the reality na kakayanin. Kaya nga sabi ko, yung hindi nakaya ng OIC, baka makaya ng Presidente. If the President has vision and political will, and similarly also Nur Misuari, na ma-achieve tong federalism, at least for Mindanao, for the next 2 or 3 years. Of his administration.
Now, speaking of the OIC, it's as if the OIC actually left, but it has been part of the MNLF and government peace process.
Yes.
Since the 70s in Tripoli.
Right.
Now, there was a statement coming from the president's spokesman. He said that Nur Misuari wants the OIC again involved in this new process or continuation of process with President Duterte. Let's talk about how crucial the role of the OIC is.
May perception nung panahon ni President Marcos at President Fidel V. Ramos at to a certain extent ni President Gloria Macapag-Arroyo na talagang very crucial ang role ng OIC. As a matter of fact, during the time of President Gloria Macapag-Arroyo with Jess Doreza and Rafael Segui's ambassador, na meron tayong application to be member, at least observer status sa OIC because of the crucial role ng OIC. Not only because yun yung club ng mga Islamic countries, there are 57 of them, but most of the petroleum countries, producing countries na Muslim ay member din ng OIC. As a matter of fact, yung OIC ang nag-pave nung first agreement nung 1976, the Triple Agreement. So internationally, including the assistance, Islamic Development Bank, at saka meron mang wherewithal, kaya lang nawala yung boses ng OIC during the Middle East crisis. Ano? Mm-hmm. But they're finding their voice again. So it is for this reason, I think, that President Duterte believes na OIC is also another elephant that we have to harness in the peace and development of Mindanao, hindi lang yung Malaysia, no? So, pati Indonesia nga, part ng whole OIC, nasa sideline nitong latest peace agreement. So, by going back to the OIC, palagi ko, we are trying to pull together all these Islamic countries and resources for the development of Mindanao, hopefully in the federal state of Mindanao.
Now, in terms of credibility and reputation, how is it when it comes to Nur Misuari before the OIC at this time?
Well, Nur Misuari is...
Because the context is in the 70s before the Tripoli Agreement. Yeah. He campaigned hard the OIC.
Right. The OIC...
To acknowledge the problems in Mindanao then.
But the OIC has not changed its policy because the OIC continues to recognize the MNLF as the sole and legitimate representative of the Bangsa Moro. Yung Bangsa Moro, ang spelling ng Bangsa tsaka Moro, hindi isang
hindi
Bangsa
diretso.
Moro. And then it recognizes also the Nur Misuari as the spokesperson of the Bangsa Moro. It is for this reason that Nur Misuari continues to participate now that Duterte gave him, sabi natin, leave. Kasi hindi siya maka-attend noon, ano? To attend the OIC, pati yung preparation niyan. So if Nur Misuari is present in the OIC, so he enjoys that stature. And I've seen this because I attended some of the meetings of the OIC, dala ko ni Nur Misuari noon, no? So na he's considered, even to the present, as one of the parang dignitary, ng state leader talaga ng Muslim countries. Tsaka one more thing, establishment din. Matanda na, tsaka he has been there since the 70s, ano? So, yeah. Mayroon siyang tradisyon na established, nakaugat. Oh, so,
actually, that reputation, the stature was mentioned in the biography of former Executive Secretary Eduardo Ermita. Mm. He recalled that meeting in Tripoli.
Right, right.
The status that was accorded to Nur Misuari.
Right, right.
Pantay na pantay sila with the representatives of the government. Actually,
right.
more cars provided. better vehicles provided.
Better vehicles. At tawag nga, Moro car. Kasi nakasakay ako doon eh. Matanda ko ng mga Islamic OIC meeting. Kaya meron kaming reserve na Moro car. Meron kaming mga ID talaga. Oo. Kaya kinu-question pa rin yung presence ng Philippine government na hindi man sila member. Mm. So pinalis din ng Misuari kaya umatend lang sila nung committee na tackling on the peace agreement nung 1996 agreement.
Now, but in this case, how do you address criticism saying that Nur Misuari had his chance over and over again and now he's still pushing for what he wants? But he had his chance already.
Right, right. That is a legitimate criticism naman. Pero on the other hand, being close to Chairman Nur Misuari, siguro partial din ako, no? Na kung merong siguro mistake ang MAAS, it is putting the people na mag-manage ng autonomous region during his time. So if you look at the chairman now, pati yung kanyang quote, isa lang ata, no? Luma ako nga, napapahiya. No? And yung kanyang simplicity, na kanyang lifestyle, and he remains poor. No? So yung mga accusation ng graft and corruption, these two icons, Salamat and Nur Misuari, lived very simple life and very poor.
Yeah, actually, Father, I'm not referring to the corruption allegations, but on the mismanagement.
Mismanagement. Sabi ko yung right, putting the right person sana in charge. Ano? He trusted eh. Kasi naman si Nur, going around conferences, I remember during the time of Ramos telling me, the can you tell the Maas Father Jun to stay there? Ano? Because he was the speaker everywhere, no? So he hardly attended to the affairs of the autonomous region and the SPC. But we met monthly, no? So since I'm second only to him in the SPC-PD Consultative Assembly. But one thing I like of Nur Misuari is that once I remember first speech, I said, Chairman, you use inclusive language na ho. Hindi na ho puro bangsa mo tsaka Muslim, ano? And he followed. After that, meron siyang series of to the Muslim, to the Christian, to the indigenous people, and to the all inhabitants of the SPCPD. Yeah. Sabi mo pa, pati gender, sinaban niya, male and female. He listens so long as you are able to talk to him.
Now, the question now is, what will be the big difference if this administration delivers on those issues
on federalism
still raised by Nur Misuari
this time around? Kasi hindi siya solo eh, because mayroong concrete guidance si President Duterte. Siguro what was lacking then was the supervision of the national government supervision over the autonomous region. Until now it is lacking eh. The national government doesn't know how to do away with it, how to manage it siguro, no? Because even in the law now, the government has the supervision over the BARM. Mm-hmm. Noon pa man, the national government has the supervision over the autonomous region in Muslim Mindanao. But that was never exercise. Parang binayaan na lang sila ganon. So this time around, I think President Duterte, hopefully when they come up with the coordinating council, or if the federalism comes to be true, no, in the next 3 years, magkaroon talaga ng supervision, working together, national government as well as this federalism.
Now, is there enough time to deliver on that promised federalism? Because paano yung mangyari? You know, the problem with the MILF, diba?
Right.
The location that they dominate, that rule over in Mindanao, and you have the Basulta region.
Right.
So, ano yung nakikita niya? So, basically, saan mapupunta ang Sulu? Which?
Palagi ko naman eh, pag nagkaroon ng federal state ang Mindanao through the popularity of the president, kakayanin niya eh kung gugusin niya, no? Because Congress eh, kahit yung konting, allowing it lang for Mindanao, kahit ni pa the whole country, no? Kung gradual yun, ano? That kind of amendment ng constitution, kakayanin ng presidente kahit yung Kongreso lang magdawa noon, ano? At least for the federal state of Mindanao. Sa palagi ko, kaya ng presidente, no? So, and then with that, yung island provinces, they will be given option to have a separate autonomy within that federal state of Mindanao. Kasi with the present BARM, though they are part of BARM because they are part of the autonomous region, we have to remember that Sulu voted no
They want out.
They want out of that autonomous region in Muslim Mindanao and BARM. Though kasali sila and there's a pending question sa Supreme Court, walang decision, pero that is there, you know, we cannot deny that. That's another elephant that we cannot deny.
Yeah, but honestly, can you convince the rest of the inhabitants, the politicians in Mindanao, to embrace that one Mindanao proposal?
Eh, palagay ko, with the phenomenal popularity of President Duterte, he will be able to do it. Eh, itong mamang ito is very powerful and very popular. What he wants, he gets, ano? Even sa, nagulat ako sa last election, ano? So, if the president with his social capital, which is very high, and his phenomenal popularity, palagay ko, he will be able to manage it. Mm. But condition yun eh, yung political will ng presidente and to push through. And then he has a ready ally, and that is Nur Misuari. And the rest of Mindanao leaders, I think, will follow the president when it comes to federalism.
But again, he has less than 3 years left.
Yes, I know. But Congress is within the grips of the president. I don't know if I can say the same thing with the Supreme Court, but seemingly na there is what we call the president's strong influence, if not manage and control, over the structures of government now.
Because the Supreme Court basically has not decided on the petition raised by the people from Sulu.
Right.
Now, before we end, I'd like to discuss briefly the situation now in the BARM, because there's the expected decommissioning.
September 7.
The next phase. Now, how they actually ascertain the decommissioning of these weapons and former combatants of the MILF, because this is a very important element in the normalization process.
Yes, that is true. Actually, 30% of this will be decommissioned ng kanilang firearms na inventory na, no? Inventory, tsaka yung troops. They have 35 to 40,000 combatants, and there are about, sabi natin, 10,000 or 11,000 weapons to be decommissioned. Kaya lang sabi ng MILF, hindi man na lahat they possess that firearms. Others, mayroong ownership dun sa arms na yun. But sa September 7, ang expected is 1,900 troops at saka about 900 firearms will be decommissioned. Decommissioned means it will be put beyond use or sa safekeeping, you know. At yun namang 1,900, there will be special program in terms of mainstreaming them. So we don't use the word surrender, but mainstreaming the combatants. Mm-hmm. At yung weapon naman ay putting, sabi natin, beyond use and safekeeping.
Mm. So basically, these were validated lahat to?
Yes, ng independent decommissioning body. Mm. Headed by Turkey's ambassador, Norway, Brunei, and some representatives from the Philippine government and MILF.
And so far, how is the MILF somehow running the transition government? It will be for the next 3 years until 2022.
Yes. It's hard to determine this early for the simple reason they don't have the budget yet. They're enjoying the budget of the old autonomous region in Muslim Mindanao. So nandun pa sila sa bird pang kasi new structure, new relationship. So nasa bird pang ka ngayon, no? Nangangapa ka. So hopefully they'll find their way when all the 8 codes that they have to do, particularly the administrative code, maging smooth running na yun. Hopefully.
Well, Father Jun Mercado, thank you very much for joining us.
Okay, thank you, Christian.
Thank you. Thank you for watching. Now, for more videos, subscribe to the official ANC YouTube channel and click the I button.